Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PyCharm, that is PyCharm version 2024.2 on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World Python program and how to run that within our PyCharm. Should you watch the video till the end, I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be successfully able to install your PyCharm and you can start working on all your Python assignments. So now, if you face any issues, you can always comment in your comment sessions and you can also ask your questions on my Instagram account. So I'm going to put the link in the description. You can follow me and you can ask all of your doubts right over there, including screenshots and everything. Alright, I'll definitely try to help you. Now to install PyCharm, you first need to go to favorite browser and you need to search over here, PyCharm download, hit enter. So that's going to show you this www.jetbrains.com. So just simply click on this download PyCharm and it's going to redirect to official site of JetBrains PyCharm. So this link I'm going to provide right in your description. So once you are here, you'll see that our PyCharm is available for Windows, macOS and Linux. So you need to switch to all these different tab to download the latest version of PyCharm. So you know, I'm going to use it for Windows. I'm going to switch to this Windows tab. I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to click on this PyCharm Community Edition. So I need to click on this download button and immediately you'll see thank you for your download and it is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this and minimize my browser. Go to my download directory and here you can see that PyCharm is already been downloaded over here. You can see the file size also, it is only 585 MB. Alright, so to install, just simply double click on the exe. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes and there you go. Welcome to PyCharm Community Edition setup. So let's minimize our download directory and here you can just simply click on next. So this is where our PyCharm is going to be installed. So you need to check this available space. So currently I'm having 121.5 GB, which is totally fine. You need to just simply check that how much available space you are having. So you need to have at least 1.8 GB of free space. All right, so that's the only thing that is what you need to check. Apart from that, everything is totally fine. Just simply click on next. So here under installation options, you need to select first this PyCharm Community Edition. So it's going to create a desktop shortcut. So that's going to help you to launch PyCharm every single time. So I'll always recommend that. Along with that, you need to also check this add open folder as project. So again, that's going to make your task much easier. So whenever there is a folder, on right clicking, it's going to show this open folder as a project, one additional option. So that's going to help you in future. So along with that, you need to also check this .py, so it will be a Python language. So Python basically has a file extension of .py, so that's why you need to select that. So whichever file your system going to have, who have a file name extensions of .py will be associated with PyCharm. Alright, so that's why we are checking this. Along with that, I'm also going to recommend you to select this add bin folder to path. This is like the most important part. So you need to always select this and you need to click on next. So it's going to create a JetBrains folder, which is totally fine. Simply click on install. And you can see that our installation is rightly begun. Also, our desktop shortcut is properly created over here. So PyCharm Community Edition 2024.2. I can always click on the show details to see how it is installing all the stuff. So it's going to take some time, couple of minutes. So by the time it get installed, do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. That will really motivate me to make more such videos. Along with, if you're interested, also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And also don't forget to follow us on our Instagram. And you can ask all of your doubts, right over there. I'm definitely going to help you. So now you can see it is properly installing. Let's, come back after a couple of minutes. So welcome back. And now you can clearly see that our PyCharm Community Edition is successfully installed. It is telling whether you like to reboot your system now or you like to manually reboot later. I always recommend you to reboot your system now. So just, you know, click on finish to restart your system. So after restarting your system, let's come back to this video again. Yeah. So welcome back. So after successfully rebooting your system, you'll begin landed over to your desktop, and here you can see our PyCharm Community Edition desktop shortcut. So let's just simply double click on it to start launching our PyCharm. You can see it is rightly started launching PyCharm Community 2024.2, and it has rightly launched. So first it will ask whether you'd like to import your previous settings from Visual Studio Code. So, you know, again, I have made a little video about Visual Studio Code. So all the settings, whatever you have done over there, you can just simply click, you know, import all that by just simply clicking on a button of Visual Studio Code. But if you haven't installed Visual Studio Code, you can just simply click on skip import and, you know, let's start everything as a fresh. So welcome to PyCharm. Let's maximize it. Click on new project. So let's create a new project. So, you know, remove everything and give something like hello everyone as our Python project name. So on our C users directory, it's going to create a PyCharm projects folder, and within that folder it's going to create hello everyone as a project. So you can see the entire file path over here, right? C users, then PyCharm projects, then hello everyone. Next, you can also check this create a welcome script. So it's going to automatically create one welcome script for you, so you don't need to, you know, write for that. And it is also telling which versions of Python you'd like to install. So if you click on that, you'll be able to see all these different versions, right? So from here, let's, you know, download the latest one at the time I'm making of this video, which is 3.12.3. So now just keep everything default and click on create. So you can see it is rightly started, you know, creating our project. So first it will download Python version 3.12.3, then it's going to install it, and parallelly it's going to also create our projects. So you need to have active internet connection, so it's going to take a couple of minutes. So after that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back. So you can see that our Hello World project is rightly open along with this article. So all new features that are there on PyCharm 2024.2, you can always read this. So maximize this and you can always read this beautiful article. For now, let's, you know, switch to our main.py file. So here is, you know, one welcome script they have already written. So it is a main method, so it is a print method. So print hi, so that print hi method is simply printing hi and then PyCharm. So whatever you are passing, you know, of when you are calling this print hi method, so whatever value you are passing, it's going to just simply print that by putting hi before that. Alright, so if you just simply click on the run button, it's going to show you the output hi PyCharm over here. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of PyCharm on a Windows operating system. I highly recommend you do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. That will really motivate me to make more such videos. Along with, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And if you face any issues, you can always ask me on comment sessions along with screenshots and everything on our Instagram account. I'll definitely going to help you. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.